Good evening. This is Boaz Zetterberg, and today's discussion is robot work envelope. We will take a look in this presentation at a few robot types. We will look at the specification of a work envelope. We'll look at the graphical solution and analytical solution for work envelope. The reason why work envelope is important, as we see in this presentation, is if we have a object, in this case it's a human patient that is being treated by a cobot. It's a collaborative robot that has an applicator which is in contact with the human body. And the applicator has to confine to a given space. And if it has to approach the body within this envelope, we have to make sure that the robot, which is being selected for that application, will be able to move in XYZ coordinate system plus pitch your roll of the gripper within the work envelope of the object. Now, the simplest form of a work envelope is of a rectangular robot, which is called PPP, which is standing for prismatic. These are the joint, one prismatic, two for this axis, and up and down for the Z. So the work envelope is simply X, Y, and Z. We have a cylindrical robot, which is called sometimes RPP, R for being revolute, providing the yaw, and prismatic in the Z and prismatic in the radial direction. So the cylindrical work envelope will be pi times RO, which is the outside diameter, will provide the surface area of the outer diameter. If we multiply that by H, we'll get the volume of the outer diameter. And since the robot cannot reach the inner portion of the cylinder, we have to subtract from it the volume of the inner cylinder, which is pi times RI squared times H. These images are taken from Czech.com. A more complex work envelope is of the spherical robot. And what we can do when we solve the envelope space with analytical formulation, what we're trying to do is to fit certain known geometrical objects, such as a sphere or a cylinder, to the description of the work envelope. So here we have a spherical robot, which has a revolute for the yaw. It has also a revolute for the pitch, and it has a prismatic joint for the radial direction. So this is like a universal joint which is providing a spherical envelope. Now the robot is limited in how high it can move and how low it can move. Therefore the cylinder is truncated, and also in a yaw direction the rotation is limited to a certain angle. So with that said, if we look at the cross-sectional view from the front, then we will see this cross-section here, and we'll see cross-section on the other side, which is also being truncated by this wedge. So given some parameters, such as the height of the inner sphere, which is on the lower side, and the height of the outer sphere, which is being truncated on the lower side, and similarly not shown, but we have the height of the upper truncated segment of the inner and the outer spheres, we have these parameters plus theta, we can calculate the work envelope using analytical formulations of these geometries. So 4/3 times pi times the outer radius cube minus the inner radius cube will provide us the volume of the sphere less the internal sphere. So that's basically the segment in between the spheres. But from that we have to deduct the truncated hemisphere, which is given by this equation, 1/3 pi times h upper squared times 3 rho r0, which is the radius of the outer space of the cylinder, of the sphere, minus the height of the truncated segment, h of the upper segment of the outer sphere. And then we have to subtract from that the inner portion of the sphere. All of that is being subtracted from the hollow sphere. And we have to do the same thing for the lower portion. So these are known formulas which can be Googled out or used simply from this presentation. And they are being used when we do analytical calculation. Once we find out what is the hollow sphere less the truncated upper and lower segments, then we can actually use, since symmetry holds, we can take the portion of the sphere which is active, which is simply theta divided by 360 degrees. So this is the analytical expression to approximate a spherical work envelope. Now, a more complicated situation is a work envelope of an articulating robot, sometimes referred to as RRR, which is Revolut for the yaw, Revolut for the pitch of the arm and the other arm, two arms. And we're looking at the actually envelope of the tool center point, which is at this point. So in a specification of a robot manufacturer, we can see a detailed description of the work envelope. Now, since it is actually symmetric in the top view, we see that we can actually ignore the left-hand side and approximate this area, which is on a cross-section, with the known cylinders, or, for example, over here we have a cone. And doing that, we can again estimate the work envelope using some analytical formulation. So in this particular case, we can take and fit a circle over here using the parameters which are given to us over here, which has the outer radius of 1.4 meters. This is over here, C. This is C, and C is 1.412. So we can use that for the outer circle. Then we have an inner circle, which is Ri, and Ri seems to be equal to E, which is 531 millimeter. So we can use this value, and we see that the base of the cone is also about the same size if you want to fit a cone over here. And so you see that here, and then H is given to us as 976 minus 400, so it's 576. And then theta is 310 degrees. Now, with that information, we can calculate the outer sphere, and which is 4/3 times pi times ro cube minus ri cube. And then we have to subtract the height of the cone, which is 1/3 pi r squared times h. Given that, plugging in the values, we can estimate the volume of the articulating robot over here. It's KUKA KR5, is 9.4 meters square. Now, the specification over here says 8.4 meters square. So see that we have in, actually, with this scheme, generated an error of 12%. We can also use graphical technique, which could be a little bit more accurate. We can mimic on a CAD system these values, the 14, 12 millimeters. We can draw that to size, and at the 976, we can put to size the 513 that we showing over here. We can also put to size, and then try to construct the volume as shown here. And whenever needed, we can do the calculation. It was easier to actually do the surface of revolution and rotate to generate the volume. And when we do this, we get 8.837. This is using SketchUp CAD system. And multiply that times 310 divided by 360 gives us 7.57 meter cube. And that again generates an error of 9%. So this basically concludes our presentation, showing you different techniques, either graphical or analytical, to estimate a work envelope of a robot. Thank you.